I had one of my viewers go ahead and ask and drop a comment down below, and because I respond to all of my questions on my channel, I'm making this video at a viewer's request. Rajesh asked if I could make a video on how to go ahead and tweak my computer for better gaming performance. So let's get started. Now, if you're new to my channel, every Tuesday I make Tech Support Tuesday videos, and every Friday I make more in-depth technical videos for mega nerds like me. Real quick, I just want to say you do not want to be jumping around in this video. You want to watch the whole thing through its entirety because there is so much information that will help you tune your system, whether it be for gaming or just regular overall system performance. All right, so all computers have what's called a BIOS, and yours may or may not look like this one here, but this is a Lenovo IdeaPad. And if you come on over to configuration, and you can see the system performance mode, the default is set to intelligent cooling. Now, what this is going to do is this is going to make the system run a little bit cooler, but at the cost of less performance. So if we go ahead and select that and hit enter, and then come on down to extreme performance, this small tweak right here can make a significant difference on your machine. Now, this will work on both Windows 7, 8, 10, and even 11. And if you hold down the Windows key and press pause break, it will bring up your system settings. Or you can open up Explorer, right click on this PC, and then go to properties, and that will bring up the same screen. Now, what you're looking for here is advanced system settings. So if we click on that, then up here you will see performance. Then click on settings. And then if you just go ahead and click on adjust for best performance, this will turn off additional components in Windows, such as like the animation elements and transparencies and stuff. And all of that adds to the overhead of your system running. So by turning all these features off, yes, it's not going to look as pretty as it did before. However, you're going to squeeze a little bit more performance out of your system. So I'm gonna hit okay. The Windows 11 doesn't crash on me. All right. And okay. And I lost my background. Yeah. Gotta love all the bugs in Windows 11. Next, we're gonna go ahead and take a look at some power management settings on your system. Now, depending on your processor, you may or may not have access to be able to really change any of these settings. I will go ahead and leave a link down in the description below on how to manually set the power configuration if it is supported by your processor. Now, how to get there, we just go ahead and hold Windows and press the letter R, type in control, and bring up the control panel. Then in the top right, we will type in power. Next, I will click on choose a power plan. Now, right now my system is set to balanced, and if I click on change plan settings, and change advanced power settings, we can see what it is by default, where the minimum processor state is 0% and the maximum is 100%. I'm just gonna cancel out of this and come back. I'm going to go ahead and select high performance, click change plan settings again, and then change advanced power settings. Now, if I expand out the processor power management again, here you will see that it is set to 100% for the minimum as well as 100% to the maximum. And since we have this selected here, all we got to do is close it out, and that's it. Now, if your system is always overheating, you can also come into the power settings and reduce the maximum CPU utilization from 100% down to, say, 99, 98, or 97%, so that the processor will be throttled by the operating system and typically won't run as hot. But I'll go into a few other things here in a little bit that will also help you out if your machine is running hot. Now, with whatever graphics card you have, whether it be AMD or NVIDIA or even Intel, there is a way to be able to tweak that for performance. So let's go ahead and go over that. I'm going to just click on start and type in NVIDIA because I have a NVIDIA card. And you can see there is a NVIDIA control panel. So click that once it opens. Here there is adjust image settings with preview. Now the default is to let the 3D application decide, but you can override that and say that you want the most performance. You just drag it over to the far left and hit apply. Then we'll close that out. Now the next thing we're going to do is hold down the Windows key and press the letter R and then type in msconfig. Then we're going to come over to the boot tab, make all boot settings permanent, advanced options, and then check the box here for number of processors and select the maximum that you have for your processor. I'm running a Ryzen 5950X and that has 32 threads. Hit okay, and then apply, and then yes, Now, the next thing you want to take a look at, and this is something you'll have to go through and research on your own because there is no master list of what to do. But if we click on services and then hide all Microsoft services, these are all the different services that are being loaded by the system. So since I go ahead and manually update Adobe Acrobat and don't really care to be using Bonjour, I just uncheck those there. But again, it really just depends on your particular system and needs. Now, if we go to Startup and click Open Task Manager, we will also see a list of items that are enabled or disabled. So if we sort by status, you can see I disabled Cortana, Skype, Spotify, and so on. And close that out, hit OK, and then go ahead and restart it so the settings that you just changed will be applied. Think of it as if like you're building a race car. You have a base model car, and then you start pulling out items to go ahead and reduce the amount of weight that is inside the vehicle. And by lowering the total weight of the vehicle, that same motor can then propel the vehicle faster without any actual physical upgrades, just by removing some items. And that's basically what you're doing when you start disabling different services and removing things out of your startup items, as it's one last thing for your computer to have to load and run in the background. So after you have everything configured in Windows and in your BIOS, if you're able to make changes in the BIOS, then what you want to do is actually start cleaning out your components. So this, for example, is a graphics card, and you can just get some canned air here and then just blow it into the fan to clean it out. Now, you can also use canned air to clean out your heatsink and fan on your processor, which if the processor is thermally throttling, then it can help restore some of that speed that it's lost just because you're cleaning it up where it's no longer dirty anymore. Now, if you've been running your system for several years, you might want to consider just getting some thermal paste and taking it apart, at your own risk, of course, cleaning it up with isopropyl rubbing alcohol, and then putting on some new thermal paste. Now, what this can do is if the old paste is just dried out and it's not really conducting all that well, then this will restore the conductivity between the processor and the heatsink. Now, before putting some money into your system and actually upgrading it, you want to be able to determine what is the actual bottleneck when you're doing things. Now, to go ahead and do that, hold down the Control, Shift, and Escape keys, and that will open up the Task Manager. Now, if we go ahead and come over to Performance here, we can see the processor, memory, disk, Ethernet, GPU, and so on are all in here. Now, say you have this open, and you go ahead and open up a game. Now, the game might be in front of it, but the Task Manager is still running in the background. So what you can do is hold down Alt and press the Tab key, and it will switch the application, so it'll bring the Task Manager up to the foreground, and you'll be able to see what kind of system resources are being utilized by that application that you're currently running. So, if you're playing a game and the CPU is pegged out at 100%, then you know that that is the bottleneck. Same thing with the memory and even the disk, at least to a degree. Now, some of the easiest upgrades that you can do in a system are adding a stick of memory or two, or upgrading from a standard hard drive over to a solid state disk. Now, the big difference between these is that you're gonna get close to like 10 times the performance out of a solid state because there's practically no seek time versus with a mechanical drive, you have an arm that's on the inside that actually has to move around, think of it as like a record player, to be able to find and reconstruct the data because of what's called fragmentation. Now, with a solid state drive, there still is fragmentation. However, since there's no moving parts, everything that you do on a solid state drive is basically like instant, just like slapping that like button and also subscribing if you haven't already. Now, I do have some other videos. I'll go ahead and put the links down in the description below on various different system upgrades. I'll just go ahead and create like a playlist for you guys so you can check that out as well. Lastly, I want to go over what's called overclocking, and just think of it a way as forcing your hardware to go faster than what it was designed to do. Although there is the possibility you could actually damage your hardware. So only do this after doing a lot of research and at your own risk, where you can decide on whether or not risking your hardware is worth trying to get a couple more frames per second out of your machine and generating a lot more heat and typically using more power as well. Now, on the flip side of things, there is something that's called undervolting, but I'm not gonna really go into detail on that other than it's basically the reverse of overclocking, so that you can kind of save power or be more efficient. So So I'll go ahead and leave a couple of links in the description down below on overclocking as well as undervolting. Basically, you're going into your BIOS and forcing a configuration to manually override the default performance settings of your system, which includes both RAM as well as your processor. Comment down below and tell me what kind of system you have and whether or not you're going to be doing any of these performance tweaks and what your results are. And I'll catch you in the next one.